In this video, I'm going to share the best Canva marketing tools for real estate agents. Let's go.
First and foremost, real estate templates. So when you are in Canva, you can search real estate templates. There are tons that are free and some that are available if you are a pro or a paid Canva member, but so many options, right? And I'll be honest with you, when I am looking for a template within Canva, I look for something simple. Honestly, less is more, which I think is really, really key. So, you know, for example, this first one, I love this first one because it's super simple, minimal text. So I'm going to click on this. The beautiful part about any Canva template is that it'll pop up right here and you can decide if you want to customize it or not. I'm going to click customize this template. And from here, it's going to pull it right into my Canva. And then I can easily change these images. So you can see here, I've got these different images here. On the left-hand side, we've got uploads. Now, by the way, my Canva dashboard might look a little bit different than yours. Canva just went through a major upgrade. So if it doesn't look exactly the same, do not fret. So the left-hand side, this is where you're going to upload any of your photos. I've already got some listing photos right here. I'm just going to click on each one of these and I'm going to delete these photos. Just click that delete button. And now what I'm going to do is just drag over my photos. One there. Let's drag over this one. And let's drag over one more right there, right? So I could leave this as is. Of course, I'd want to change the actual address. So if it was 123 Main Street, right? Any city, and we could leave it as is. I do recommend that you change it based on your branding. So if your colors are red, white, and blue, or if your colors are, hot pink or whatever your colors are, change those. If you have a pro account with Canva, you probably have your brand kit set up, which is great because you can upload your colors and your logos and fonts and everything. But even if you have a free account, you can still update this. So for example, if I wanted to click on that, I might change that background to white. And then I would probably change the font to my font or a font that that was closer to my brand. So let's change that to this and let's change that to this. And I probably would also change the size a little bit so we can make this a little bit bigger and really kind of make this pop like that, right? I'm gonna bring that down just a little bit. I'm gonna bring that in right there. Okay, pretty simple. Of course, I could add my logo. I'm gonna go up to my brand kit. Again, if you have a pro account, you can also add your logos, which is great. So I've got all my logos right here. I can click on my logo and I'm gonna just kind of drag it, make it small, put it in the corner. Sometimes this is a little bit tricky on templates. So I don't know if I am actually going to do this or not. I actually might just leave my logo off. But a little hack, if you're having trouble adding your logo, I'm gonna add my handle. I love doing this. This is a great way to add your branding without necessarily having your logo over everything. Now, double check with your broker because some brokers require your logo, but if you can get away with just putting your handle on something, it's a nice way to personalize your content without having to put your logo splashed everywhere. Okay, so I've got my name right down there in the corner. That's my Instagram handle. And there we go. So it's just, kind of subtly off to the side there. I can also click effects and make that pop a little bit. Let's bring that intensity up. So there you go. That's super simple. Now you'll notice up at the top, it has the name of the template. I would change this to whatever your property is, 123 Main Street, right? And once you've created one piece of content, you could easily rinse and repeat. So that is a big thing I'd recommend. Don't reinvent the wheel every single time. Pick a template you like and then rinse and repeat. So I can go up here to resize and magic switch, and I can go down and also take this from a graphic to a reel. So let's hit Instagram reel and we're gonna hit copy and resize. And I wanna keep this original one. So let's hit copy and it's going to resize it into a video. So now this is something I could use for a reel or a story or a TikTok. And you can see it is just a 5-second video right there, pretty easy. I could even click animate if I wanted to and just kind of animate the text a little bit. That's an easy way to, just sort of animate the video, really easy. And then I would download that. I am doing this on my computer, but I would, if I was an agent, go to my phone, download this through the Canva app. That way it's to my phone and then you can upload it, add some music, add a little bit of text in the caption, which is important as well, where you're going to want to give all the details. So now you've created a graphic for social media, you've created a video that you could post at some point, and you could continue this process. I'm going to go back to my original graphic here, and I could go back up to resize and magic switch. And maybe there's some other things that you do. Maybe you do a postcard. Let's do 8.5 by 5.5. So maybe you do some just listed that you're sending out to your market. Again, you can copy and resize. And by the way, you can print through Canva. I have printed note cards. I have printed flyers. I have printed all kinds of stuff through Canva. The quality is great. It gets to you really fast, which is fabulous as well. So now this is resize it for a postcard, which is really fantastic. And what's nice about this, when you're resizing stuff for print, it's also on the right-hand side going to show you, first of all, you can order these right here. You can see how you can order them. And then it's going to prompt you to create a front page and a back page. So with your back page, that's where you're going to want to, of course, add in, you know, additional information, et cetera, et cetera. And that's where you can also add in like your matte finish. What do you want? Square corners, et cetera. And you can see the pricing right there, which is pretty cool. This is specifically for a listing, but think about this in terms of just any of your marketing. If you're doing content around community content, around just listed, just sold, around real estate tips, you could follow this route, kind of follow this process of picking a template, resizing, rinse, and repeat. Okay, a couple other quick things that I want to share really fast as we're talking about Canva marketing tools. I'm going to go back to just canva.com, and I'm going to pull up a square size Instagram sort of template. I love this size because you can use it for just about anything. And one other cool thing that you could do is I'm going to go down and pull up under apps. If you go down on the left-hand side, there are a lot of different options. And I'm going to click the apps button. There's a million different apps, but one of the ones that's really fun is the ability to add a QR code. So I know for a lot of you, you probably use QR codes on your signs, on flyers, whatever it might be. QR codes are a great way to drive people to your website or to drive people to a specific landing page. I'm going to click QR code, and now we can enter the URL. So let's say, for example, I'm going to go over to my website, and maybe I have a specific landing page on my website. Okay, I have, for example, a resources page on my website. I'm going to click on free resources, and this is a great thing to share to folks on social media. It's a great thing to share, you know, in any of your marketing. So I'm going to click that link. I'm going to go back to my QR code. I'm going to paste that in there. And then there's a little button that says customize. So I could leave it black and white, or I could customize it to my brand colors. I happen to know my brand colors off the top of my head. So we're going to pick that. I'm going to hit generate code. And now I've got a QR code where, if you'd like to scan this and test it to see how it works, it should take you over to this free resources page that we have over on our website. So again, it's untitled. I would title this, QR code freebies. And then you can copy this. If I wanted to go back over to this postcard as an example, let's say that this QR code was linked to this listing. I could always paste this over here. Let's go like that. And let's hit copy, and let's go back to that postcard, and let's hit add page right there, and let's grab this. Now, sometimes you can copy it like this. Sometimes you do need to download it. So I'm actually going to download it. Every once in a while, it gets a little funky when it comes to QR codes. So we're going to download it, and that way we've got it as a graphic, and then I can go back over to my postcard, and I'm going to click uploads. I'm going to click upload files, and I'm going to upload this. This is that QR code I just created, and I'm going to click that, and I'm going to add it. So this is really fantastic, especially for any kind of print. I love the opportunity of sort of taking the online offline, right? So if you've got a postcard, obviously you would want to design the back, but maybe on the back, you know, you've got some verbiage here about the listing. You're going to have some information about you and who you are. But it would be nice to have a QR code that goes right to what that listing is all about. That's the same QR code you can put on signs, on flyers, whatever it might be. So one last thing I want to share really, really fast that you can do in Canva, and it really has nothing to do with templates, which we love. So we're just going to go to canva.com. And the beautiful thing I'm going to share really fast is you could do something without a template at all. So let's say you are in a hurry, you've got a listing, or you want to create something really quick. I'm going to share with you real fast how to create a reel for real estate that does not require any templates. Super easy to do. Anybody could do this. So I went into Canva. I searched the word reel. It's going to pull up a blank template. Again, obviously, there's lots of templates on the side here. But what I can do on the left-hand side is upload my images. And so I'm going to upload one image here like that. And we're going to make this bigger like that. We're going to make it kind of full screen right here. And then I'm just going to duplicate this a few times. Okay. So I'm just going to grab a couple house pictures. This works really well for a new listing or an open house or some sort of community post. And I'm just sort of like haphazardly throwing these in. Now, these are all stock photos, but you would obviously use real photos. Let's add that in like that. And let's add one more in. Let's add in this kitchen. Okay, so we've got this. Now, these are just images, right? So I can rearrange these. I'm gonna click around, kind of rearrange them. You can see at the bottom here that they are all going to display for about 5 seconds each. And I am going to kind of move that around like that. So I can kind of rearrange them however I'd like. What's nice about this is you can also make them shorter. Because honestly, we have zero attention span these days. So let's kind of keep it short and sweet. I'm going to make each one be on screen for about 2 seconds like that. And we're going to pull that in like that. There we go. And then I can click on text and I can add some text. And you'll notice on the left-hand side, there's lots of different text options. You could use these recently used. You could add your own text. I'm just going to use this one that's kind of fun. And I don't need it to say super mom, but I could make it larger and click on it and write something like just listed, right? And that's fun. That's kind of a fun font. You could certainly do that. You could change the fonts, of course, to be your own fonts, whatever you'd like. So we're going to make that white. We'll make that white. And there we go. So then I'm going to take that and put that in the front and we'll hit play and you can see how it's just going to play through. Now, of course, I could add some additional text to each slide if I wanted to. But there you go. I could even go up to elements and type in like comment and it's going to pull up some different graphics. Let's pull that. Maybe we want to do a little like comment share at the end. Yeah, you may have seen that before. There we go. So I just want to show this to you really fast because yes, you can use templates. Yes, you can resize stuff. The QR code thing is cool. But sometimes if you're just in a hurry and you've got a couple images, maybe you want to make a quick little slideshow for a listing or for a graphic. You don't always need a template. And this is awesome. It's easy to do. Again, just open up a blank Reels template, upload your graphics, and put them in the order you want. I like to, again, adjust them to like a second or 2 seconds because if someone's playing them, they might have to rewatch it, which is great. And if I click play, you can watch the whole thing right there. And then you can just download it to your phone, add some music, add some text, and you're good to go. So anyways, I know this video is a little robust, but I wanted to share a bunch of tips that I thought would be helpful for you, especially if you are in real estate. So a couple things, if this has been helpful for you, number one, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. We have new videos that come out each and every month. We would love for you to check that out. And number two, if you are thinking about taking your Canva training to the next level, you're stuck on Canva, you need some help with Canva, go to katielance.com/Canva Camp. We'd love for you to sign up. We have Canva Camp coming up and we are going into all things Canva for real estate. I can't wait to share them with you. Okay. I can't wait to see what you create. Let me know what you think. Like and comment below.